name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to set up the water and vinegar mixtures for our experiment. The first thing that we're going to need is something to contain our solutions in, and I'm going to use 8 clear cups for that. We'll also need to know the mass of our cups and the mass of our combined solutions. So we're going to need a scale. We're going to use approximate volumes, but we want to know exactly how much the volume of water and vinegar is that we add to our cups. And to avoid having to do the washing and drying of the graduated cylinders, I am going to use 2 graduated cylinders, both 50 milliliters. If we want to be very exact in our measurements, then we may want to use 2 pipettes, 1 for water and 1 for vinegar in this case. Also, I'm going to bring in a beaker so that I'm not going to pour from my original 5% vinegar container, and I'm going to use some deionized water that I already poured into a beaker. And finally, because I'm going to record everything, I will need a pen for this experiment. I will first pour approximately 150 to 200 milliliters of 5% vinegar into the beaker. And I can set the bottle of vinegar aside. To make sure that I'm not confusing the two, the water and the vinegar, I may label these with Sharpies, or I can set them on 2 different sides of me. This will be the water and this will be the vinegar. I'm fairly sure that you know this by now. Vinegar has a very distinct odor that will separate it from water. And then each of them gets its own pipette. So I'm going to begin with experiment 1. Experiment 1 will require a cup. I will take my cup, place it on the scale, record the mass of the cup. In this case, it is exactly 15.00 grams. Next, I am going to add 35 milliliters of water into this cup. So first, I will try to get as close as possible to the 35 milliliters using my graduated cylinder. If I am close, but just under it, I can use my pipette and get exactly to 35. In this case, it's not that important, but let me demonstrate how we can do that. And in this case, the volume of the water that I'm adding to the cup is going to be exactly 35.0 milliliters. After transfer, I will record the mass. It is 48.72 grams. For this experiment, I'm not going to get any vinegar. In future ones, I will add a combination of vinegar and water. So I will place the first cup on the paper that has experiment 1 labeled on it and still has the little red cup with the first tablet for which we already recorded its weight. On the piece of paper, I recorded both my masses. For experiment 2, I am going to use another cup that I will place on my sheet that has my experiment 2 details. I will place the cup on the scale and I will record its mass, 14.65 grams. Then I am going to add 5 milliliters of vinegar. I'm going to use the vinegar from my left side. This one is a little more than 5. It is okay because it's close to 5, and I will use the volume to track the changes that will occur later. So it was recommended that I use 5 milliliters. I used 5.9, and I want to make sure that I record that. On the other side, I'm going to measure 30 milliliters of the water. And again, I am just under it, so I'm going to add a little bit more. My measurement is 29.8 milliliters, and I will record that. Then I transfer my water inside the cup. Swirl to create a homogeneous solution, place it back on the scale, and record the combined mass, which is 48.48 grams. With this, I will place my cup on the second piece of paper and slide it back in its position. I am now ready for experiment number 3, for which I am going to increase the amount of vinegar that I'm using by 5 milliliters to 10 milliliters and decrease the volume of water from 30 to 25. It is 10.0 milliliters. Now I will place my cup on the scale, record its mass. It is 14.38 grams. Then transfer the vinegar. And then I will measure out 25 milliliters of water. And this is just under it at 24.8 milliliters. I will transfer this inside the cup as well. And the combined weight of the cup, water, and vinegar is now 47.83 grams. With this, I will swirl my water and vinegar mixture, place it on the experiment paper, and slide it back. For experiment number 4, I am going to use 15 milliliters of vinegar and 20 milliliters of water. So 15.0 milliliters of vinegar and 22.0 milliliters of water. Next, I am going to take my fourth cup, place it on the scale that says 0.00, record the mass of my cup, and that is 14.20 grams. Then I will pour the vinegar and the water, record the combined weight, 49.27 grams, swirl it together, and then place it on the sheet of paper and slide it back. For experiment number 5, we're going to use 20 milliliters of vinegar and 15 milliliters of water. Once we have our appropriate volumes of vinegar and water, we make sure that our scale is at 0.00, place our cup on top of it, record the mass of the cup, 15.13 grams. Then transfer our vinegar and our water. And then record the combined weight. In my case, it's 47.97 grams. Once done, we place the swirled, now homogenized solution onto the paper and slide it back. For experiment 6, we increase the amount of vinegar and decrease the amount of water again. We'll be using 25 milliliters of vinegar, and I will be using 10 milliliters of water. So 25.0 milliliters of vinegar and 9.9 milliliters of water. We take our sixth cup, place it on the scale, record the mass of the cup, 14.93 grams. Then we pour our vinegar and our water in it. And now we record the combined weight, 48.41 grams. We swirl it together, place it on the paper, and slide it back. We have two more to set up. Next, we're going to have 30 milliliters of vinegar and 5 milliliters of water. we record the volumes, and then we record our masses. First, the mass of cup number 7, we have to start with the scale saying 0.00. Then record the mass of the cup, 14.60 grams. Then we transfer the vinegar and the water into it. And record a combined mass, which in this case is 47.69. Finally, we give it a swirl to homogenize it, place it on the sheet of paper, and send it back. And for our final experiment, we're going to use 35 milliliters of vinegar, and that's it. This solution is exactly 35.0 milliliters, and it is all vinegar. So for water, we add 0.00 because there was nothing, and 35.0 milliliters for our vinegar. Now for the final mass, we take our cup and place it on the scale as it says 0.00. We record the mass, it is 14.46 grams. And then we transfer all the vinegar and record our final mass, 48.64 grams. Once we are ready, we don't need to give it a swirl because this is all vinegar, and we place it on the sheet for experiment 8 and slide it to the side. With this, we prepared everything we needed for our limiting reactant experiment, and we are ready for the next step.